Sir, Deco Class 11 is formed.
Okay, so we'll practice the. You have your list, don't you? Man, but then we're just going to do a quick practice first. Alright, W01 Buma. First Lieutenant Johnson. W01 Crumb. W01 Nabatis. Second Lieutenant Wynn. First Lieutenant Vela. First Lieutenant Davis. W01 Johnson, 2nd Lieutenant Morgan, W01 Faber, W01 Grimes, W01 Burnett, Captain, looks like CRT, Captain Robertson, 1st Lieutenant Medina, 2nd Lieutenant Onorobi, W02 Higante, 2nd Lieutenant Minke, 2nd Lieutenant Inigante, W03 Kennedy, 2nd Lieutenant Archelon, W02 Lee, Captain Lawyer, W01 Farley, Lieutenant Photographer.
We know that.
What's wrong?
We don't need to be speaking in formation. We got it.
I can't hear you.
Somebody in the formation.
Did I not call someone's name out?
No. Farley.
Okay. No one's missing. Okay, so, okay, it's hard to make a report. Getting my hand up here.
Sergeant Major Thompson, close.
Class 11. Out, head, jump. Right, face.
Y'all guide to the left of the pine tree.
Big guide to the left of the tree.
All word. Arms. Left. Left. Left.
You can thank McKinnon still.
I'm sorry. You can thank Dixon.
Yes, sir. You are. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You're also doing line on. straight ahead for a second.
Thank you. I almost said my old Navy term, horse plate.
I
11, it's pouring.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Welcome to Camp Swift. I am First Lieutenant Winston, and I want to welcome you to DCOOC, Direct Commission Officer Orientation Course, Class 11's closing ceremony. I do want to take a moment to welcome our special guests, including Brigadier General Kay, Deputy Commanding General, Active, the Texas State Guard, and Command Sergeant Major Tuberville, Texas State Guard Senior Enlisted Advisor, along with other military guests and family. At this time, I would like Captain Payton, our chaplain, to step forward and give an invocation.
Please, if you wouldn't mind standing and bowing your heads, please. Father, we thank you for great weather, God. We thank you for great leaders, beautiful family, God, and people that's graduating in this class of DCOOC, Father God. Father, we pray that you will continue to guide them, teach them, continue to elevate them, God, give them the strength and courage to defend the United States Constitution and the Constitution of the State of Texas, Father. And whenever the Honorable Governor Greg Abbott call upon us, let us carry out our duties, Father. We thank you, we bless you, and we honor you. In Jesus' name we say, amen.
Thank you, Chaplain. General Kay, I invite you to share some words of wisdom with the graduates with their day.
There. I promise to keep this slightly under an hour. So what I want to say to you is the following. In doing this after a federal career, coming to the Texas State Guard, every year we have managed to become better and better. I want to thank you. You may not think you're the most important people today here. You may think these people are, but you are the most important people here today. Because without you, they wouldn't be doing this, would they? If you hadn't agreed to this, they wouldn't be here. So my invitation to you is, well, if they're doing it, why aren't you? That's my recruiting thing. I want to do thank you for coming here. I want to thank everybody that came out for training. I want to thank the instructors. I want to thank the brain power that has gone into something like this to make it happen. And we are continuing to evolve, trying to meet the needs of our state, which you know are tremendous at this time. Texas is leading the way. All states, not that there aren't other great states, but they are all emulating what the Texas almost every state within the 50 wants to start a state guard of their own. So they come to us, they emulate what we do. These young ladies, the men right here, are going to be a vital part of that. They will be leading the way into the future. We're all long gone. Okay, so you have to go home sometime. They will be the ones leading this. I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart. I want to thank these individuals from the bottom of my heart for putting up with this and surviving through the third session of this. Okay? This is it. This is what they have worked for and strived for the entire time they have been out here.
There are not many more comments I need to make. This keeps me going, keeps me motivated when I see younger people coming out and stepping forward. They always say, what's wrong with the younger generation, and they said it about mine too, okay? But when you look around and say, I think we're pretty good now. So thank you for being here. I will turn it back over to you.
I thank General Cave. This is Training Evolution, Phase 3. It's the culmination of the Direct Commission Officers Training Program. These direct commission officers are professionals in their civilian careers, and they include doctors, nurses, law enforcement officers, engineers, and chaplains as well. They've begun their preparation toward their role as military officers, and this is only the beginning. As the OIC of this course, the officer in charge, I encourage each of these professional skills officers to continuously better themselves and make the Texas State Guard an even better organization. The service members standing before you have successfully completed the phase of their course of instruction. The cadre standing before you are extremely professional in both their civilian and military careers. They are called SMEs, or subject matter experts. They devote their time, they have the passion and desire to train your loved ones, helping them to become the best individuals that they can be as well. So to the families of the recruits, the Texas State Guard is one of the three branches of the Texas Military Department, along with the Army National Guard and the Air National Guard. We all serve our fellow Texans. We, the cadre, appreciate you allowing us to train your loved ones. And we hope that in addition to them learning basic soldiering skills, that they've learned something about themselves along the way. It's an honor to serve, and each of us must continually prepare ourselves so that we can answer the call of the governor and support of our fellow Texans. Each of these graduates is now the embodiment of the Texas military tradition dating back to 1823. Attention to order! Following individuals have completed the Direct Commission Officer Orientation Course, Phase 3, 22-002, with an effective date of 24 April 2022, signed Arthur G. Levesque, Colonel, Texas State Guard. Warrant Officer Vuma, First Lieutenant Johnson, Warrant Officer Crum, Warrant Officer Navarez, Second Lieutenant Wynn, First Lieutenant Vela, First Lieutenant Davis, Captain Freeburn, Warrant Officer Johnson, Second Lieutenant Morgan, Warrant Officer Faber, Warrant Officer Grimes, Warrant Officer Burnett, Captain Robertson, First Lieutenant Medina, Second Lieutenant Honorobe, Warrant Officer Gigante, Second Lieutenant Menke, Second Lieutenant Inigante, Warrant Officer Kennedy, Second Lieutenant Arcelon, Warrant Officer Lee, Captain Lawyer, Warrant Officer Farley. DCs, please pull out and affix your rank insignia. Congratulations. Give him a round of applause. Sergeant Major Thompson, host.